Welcome to SEBB Staying Connected. My name is Rob Lyden and I'm a Benefit Marketing Rep with the Healthcare Authority. So today we're going to provide you with some of the updates that have come out concerning the SEBB program. So there are some updates when it comes to forms and publications. Let's take a look at those. So let's talk about any updates when it comes to forms and publications. So there is a new 2021 School Employees Enrollment Guide that's out. And that should be directed to those new employees as an introduction to their SEBB benefits and those employees that are eligible for SEBB benefits beginning January 1st of 2021. So this guide can be viewed online on the employee and the BA website, and there's also a print version that's available to order on the BA website as well. So as a reminder, this enrollment guide is not sent out automatically every year. There's also a new 2021 School Employees Enrollment Form, which cannot be found online on the employee or the BA website. So this form must be ordered on the BA website and should only be provided to those employees without online access and cannot enroll in their SEBB benefits using SEBB My Account. As a reminder, the preferred method for employees to enroll into their SEBB benefits is using the SEBB My Account system. So let's take a look how to locate these forms and publications and also how to order these. So on the Benefit Administrator's website, you want to go ahead and click on Forms and Publications. So that'll bring you to this page here. And there's a lot of links to all the forms that are available on this page here for the SEBB program. If you scroll down just a little bit, you'll also find the Employees Medical Dental Vision section. And here you can find the School Employees Enrollment Guide for 2021 to include the School Employees Change Form for 2021. You will not find the School Employees Enrollment Form for 2021 online or on the BA website. So this form must be ordered through the BA website, and you can do that in this green box here by clicking on Order Materials. So on this page here, these are all the forms that you can order through the SEBB program here. So if you're starting from the top, you have the 2021 Premium Surcharge Attestation Help Sheet. And then the order limit is 40, which means you cannot order more than 40 of this form here. If you continue to scroll down, you'll notice that you can order the School Employees Enrollment Guide for 2021 here. And here is where you would order the new School Employees Enrollment Form for 2021. And again, the order limit is no more than 40. And it says in red here, only provide if the employee does not have online access and cannot enroll using SEBB My Account. So you can also order the School Employees Change Form here as well. If you scroll all the way down, you can also order the 2021 PEB Retiree Enrollment Guide here. So let's go ahead and order a few of these forms and publications. So let's say we want to order the School Enrollment Guide for 2021. So all you have to do is click the order box. And again, you can't order more than 60. So we're just going to order 20 there. And let's scroll down to the School Employee Enrollment Form, check the order box. And we can't order more than 40, so we're just going to put 20 in there. And once you're done, just click add all selected items to the cart. So on this form here, you'll notice it says lines in cart is 2. So we have 2 different items. And then unit in the cart is 40. So we ordered 20 of the School Enrollment Guide and 20 of the School Enrollment Form for 2021. And you can also view your shopping cart by clicking on this link here. So in order to check out, just hit the go button. And here it's going to ask you for some address information. So you would put your SEBB organization's address information here and just click submit. So what are some new employee resources that you could use as a SEBB organization? Let's take a look at a few of those. So let's talk about some resources for new employees. So the virtual benefit fair and Alex is available day or night, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So let's find out how to navigate and get to the virtual benefit fair website. So starting from the Healthcare Authority main webpage, you want to go ahead and click on Employees and Retiree Benefits right here in the center. So this is the Employee and Retirees Benefit website. And on this website, you have a lot of information for public employee section, school employee section, and then on the right here, you have retirees section here for those retiring. And if you scroll all the way down, you have additional information for those employees wanting some continuation coverage information. So at the very top of the webpage, you do have the tab News. So you want to click on that. And it'll bring you to this page here. What you want to do is go ahead and scroll all the way down. And then the bottom left corner here, you want to go ahead and click on Virtual Benefit Fair for SEBB. Which will bring you to this page here. So the Virtual Benefit Fair has benefit options and availability. It also provides information on additional benefits such as your medical FSA, your DCAP, your LTD, and your AD&D. It also has links to videos, plan comparisons, and vendor webinars. You also can access this using your computer, tablet, or smartphone. So this is what the webpage looks like. In the center here, you have an introduction video here. And then on the left-hand side, you have medical benefits, dental, and vision benefit information. You also have information on your Dependent Care Assistance Program, DCAP, also life and accidental death and dismemberment insurance information to include long-term disability information, information on your medical flexible spending arrangement, FSA, and then information on your Smart Health Wellness Program. So Alex, you can locate Alex here on the right-hand side of the website. And Alex is an interactive online benefit advisor. It's a virtual guide to help employees understand benefits. It guides and suggests health plans such as medical, dental, and vision plans available to employees. And all you have to do is click on Ask Alex right here. So what are some notice and updates that have come out with the SEBB program? Let's take a look at those. Any new notices or SEBB My Account updates can be found on the Benefit Administrator's website. And you can find that information by clicking on the top tab where it's listed Notices and Updates. So here, you can register for Gov Deliveries to stay up to date on any information or changes with the SEBB program. And if you scroll down just a little bit, you can find the SEBB My Account program updates here to include notices and any COVID-19 guidance. So there are some SEBB My Account updates I want to share with you. So on December 11th, there was an update that came out. So what this update states is the following note has been added to birth, adoption, special open enrollments. And the note states that if adding a child does not increase the premium and subscribers are past their 60 days from the SOE event, they must submit a 2021 school employee change form to their benefit administrators. So for those benefit administrators who are unable to update the employee account in SEBB My Account, can forward this 2021 school employees change form to the outreach and training via Fuse for an approved request. So on February 3rd, just recently, there was another SEBB My Account update that was sent out. And this is pertaining to the tobacco premium surcharge. So recent updates to the SEBB My Account to the tobacco premium surcharge resulted in incorrectly displaying a surcharge for employees who attested no to the tobacco surcharge. So there were no impacts to the employees being billed that $25 surcharge. So this issue has been resolved and the current tobacco premium surcharge is now being displayed correctly. So under notices, there are a few gov deliveries that were sent out. And there was one that was sent out in December 2nd, and it talks about dependent coverage elections for SOE events. So what this gov delivery states is that employees adding a dependent during an SOE event must select coverage for that dependent at that time. So employees should not wait for the dependents to be verified by the benefit administrators through the dependent verification tab. All employees need to do is select yes from the drop-down box for each benefit. Dependents will not be added if the employee does not select the desired benefit coverage during the SOE timeline, which is typically 60 days from the event. Benefit administrators should completely review all SOE events and enrollment completions prior to verifying events under the SOE verification tab. So there are some enhancements that are coming out for the SOE dependent coverage election. So you'll see those very soon. On December 23rd, there was a notice, gov delivery, that was sent out concerning CHIPRA. So CHIPRA stands for the Children's Health Insurance Program Reauthorization Act. So this message states that several organizations that maintain a group health plan in a state that provides premium assistance under Medicaid or the Children's Health Insurance Program, CHIP, must notify all employees annually of potential opportunities for premium assistance in the state in which that employee resides in. It also states that SEBB organizations are required to provide the employer CHIP notice to all employees, not just those employees who are eligible and enrolled in the employer's group health plan. So HCA does not have all the SEBB organization employee information. With that said, HCA will not distribute this notice on behalf of the SEBB organizations. There is a model employer CHIP notice that's available on the Employee Benefits Security Administration website. So in this gov delivery, it also includes a draft template to notify employees that may qualify for the health care coverage through the Washington Apple Health Medicaid program. So there has also been some guidelines for error correction. And going back to the Benefit Administrator's webpage, there are error correction guidelines for correcting errors and other error correction resources to include sample correction recourse letters that are now available on the BA website. And you can find those starting from the BA webpage by clicking on the quick reference guides. So in this section, you'll notice the links that are on everything that's listed on this page. You can scroll down to error correction. You can click on this link, or you can just scroll down the page to the error correction section. So in this section, it gives you the SEBB error correction guidelines, the WAC that covers error correction, and the administrative policy that covers error correction. Also the sample correction and recourse letters that are available to benefit administrators. If you continue to scroll down, you'll also find in this page here, the 2021 SEBB lower limit and current process month calendar, which benefit administrators should be using for this year. Going back to the benefit administrator's website here, there is 2020 W-2 guidance for reporting the cost of employer-sponsored health care coverage on IRS form W-2. It can also now be found on the benefit administrator's website. And you can find this by scrolling all the way down to rates, clicking on rates, and this will bring you to a page that covers rate information. And you can find down here the W-2 reporting. So under here, you can find the 2020 reporting, the cost of employer-sponsored health care coverage for on IRS form W-2. And you can also find the 2021 reporting, the cost of employer-sponsored health care coverage on the IRS form W-2. So the SEBB program has distributed the W-2 data at the beginning of January to each SEBB organization. They set this using the same contact information for distributing the SEBB organization form 1095 enrollment data. So this was sent to the ESD's contact listed for the district for many SEBB organizations. It was a secure email with the email address of hca.sebb.do.not.reply@hca.wa.gov. So SEBB organizations should ensure that this email does not end up as junk mail. So this message was also sent on January 7th of this year. So we are going to provide you with some reminders, tips, and resources as well. Let's take a look at a few. So there is an update with the Form 1095 enrollment data. At the beginning of January, HCA changed the way that secure emails are sent to SEBB organization, which has also changed the way that these emails are accessed. So if you're a user of Outlook 365 or 2019, you want to open the secure email without keying in a password. So for those users that have Outlook 2016, you must key in the Microsoft Outlook password or sign in with the one-time passcode option. For users that are using Outlook 2010, please contact this email address here, and HCA will send your file via Fuse. And for non-Outlook email users, please sign in with the one-time passcode option. For 2020, correction files will be provided on a monthly schedule if enrollment data from 2020 or earlier is updated. So when it comes to the SEBB appeals process, employers must review the employee's appeal, complete the employer portion of the appeals form, send the appeals form back to the employee, and if the employee should review that decision, and if they wish to continue with the appeals process, the employee should follow the directions on the appeals form. Employers should not send appeals to the appeals unit via Fuse. This could cause delay in the process of your appeal. So when it comes to name and updating your beneficiaries for life and AD&D, you can check your current beneficiaries and make changes by logging into MetLife Portal, My Benefits, then click on Beneficiaries. Or you can mail the Group Term Life Beneficiary Designation Form to MetLife. So employees should name and update their beneficiaries when it comes to a health savings account as well. To check current SEBB beneficiaries and to make changes, you can log in to their health equity account and visit the profile details webpage. Or you can complete the beneficiary designation form and mail or fax this form to the health equity. So the BA website is a great source for benefit administrators. Again, if you have any questions, you can also contact outreach and training using our 1-800-700-1555. Or you can send us a Fuse if you have any questions. So we do have a lot of recorded webinars that are posted on the BA website, as well as those presentations that we use for those webinars. And you can find that on the Benefit Administrator's webpage. So in order to navigate to that, all you have to do is scroll halfway down the page, and right here where you find recorded webinars and presentations, if you click on that, this will bring you to all our recorded webinars and as well as our presentations that we use for those. And in this, you'll find links to everything that is located on this page here. So you'll have eligibility file information, supplemental benefit billing information, eligibility webinars and presentations, the dependent eligibility webinars that we recorded, open enrollment webinar that we recorded, as well as the miscellaneous topics. And these are most of the webinars that we recorded previously, and you can find the dates that we recorded those here. And on the very bottom, you'll find presentations. So these are presentations to those webinars that you can also view at your convenience. So there is another way to access this page. And that is the shortest way. But also, if you go back to the Benefit Administrator's webpage and you click on Training Schedule and Materials, so under here, under Training Materials, that will also take you to that page, or you can click here, Visit Our Training Material webpage. So we're going to go ahead and click here under Training Materials. And you notice it brings us back to that that web page that has all our recorded webinars and presentations for you to view. So we've covered a lot during this recording. We've talked about some of the updates to some of the forms and publications. We've also talked about some of the resources for new employees, that virtual benefit fair and Alex. We've also covered a few of the notices and some of the SEBB My Account updates that have come out. And we provided you with some reminders, tips, and resources. We hope that this webinar or this recording has been very useful to help you find a lot of this information that's out there on the BA website or that's on the employees and retirees website. So thank you for watching.